I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter. I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter. I like peanut butter.
Hello.
Hi.
It's me. Okay, so welcome. This is the Labor Day Cheap Geek podcast, or the Cheap Geek Labor Day podcast. Choice is yours because you probably don't have to work today.
Yeah.
And if you do have to work, I apologize in advance. And if you're listening to this after Labor Day has already occurred, well, then it doesn't really matter then, does it?
No.
So anyway, what is the episode title for this time?
It is Labor Day, Ikea Testicle Stool, and We Got Robbed.
Yeah. Dun, dun, dun. Okay, so basically what it boils down to is all those things that are in the title are interesting. And you get to pick which is interesting for you. So normally what happens is that we just make a podcast and roll with it, but we thought we might do a little bit of a Labor Day podcast to celebrate the working person.
Yeah.
Working stiff. The employed.
Yeah.
You know, because that's what we are. We're working people. We work. We work for what we got. It's just kind of what we do. And every once in a while, we get a break. And we thought that we'd have a wonderful break this time, go out and do some stuff and celebrate the Labor Day.
No.
No. Bum, bum, bum. Dumb stuff has occurred, and so why not make a podcast about it?
Yeah.
Yeah. But I will say this. The Ikea Testicle Stool just lets us know that no matter how bad you got it, it's always worse for somebody else.
I'm cringing at the name.
I'm excited. It's funny.
I'm not. Ugh.
Yeah. So here we are. It is Labor Day or soon thereafter or whatever, and you're listening to this podcast. Very much appreciated. And you can listen to this podcast on many different places in many different ways. iTunes, on Stitcher, which is like radio on demand, and Google Play, and YouTubes, and a website,
Libsyn.
Well, we have a website, and Facebook, and everywhere else. But anyway, thanks for listening. We do appreciate it. And so here we go. So Labor Day occurs, and there are people on the days off, and we just kind of
just take it for granted as a nice day in September to have off.
Yeah, a little grilling going on, you know. And after the holiday is over, you can't wear white. There's all these little weird rules and stuff. So I was thinking about it, and I was going through taking a look and saying what I would like to talk about on Labor Day, and what I figured is this: what is Labor Day all about?
I have no idea.
Me either.
Thought it was like some sort of
like Hallmark holiday.
No, more like I originally thought it was like something to do with like the military at first.
Hmm.
Yeah, nope. I never really knew.
Do you know what Hallmark holiday is?
Yeah, it's one that was created as a marketing ploy, kind of like Sweetest Day, which I think is like in October. Hmm. And it was purposely invented as an excuse to go buy candy for someone significant in your life.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, because Valentine's Day.
Oh, but see, Valentine's Day is in February. Yeah. So it made it out so that holidays like February, Christmas, and New Year's were the only days people really bought sweets. Oh, and Easter.
Well, that's crap.
So, you know, there was a big dry spell in the middle of the year. So Hershey's actually created Hershey's and Hallmark and a couple other places. They came up with Sweetest Day so that you'd go buy candy in October.
Yeah, because we don't do it for Halloween.
I know, but this was just like, I don't know. This was like another way, like the confectionery.
Another way they could stick it to us. He's trying to take our monies, man.
Like the fancy candy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So here's what it says. You've worked hard all day, and damn it, you deserve 3 solid days of backyard grilling and Labor Day cocktails. As Aristotle put it, the end of labor is to gain leisure.
Okay.
And to that end, we've compiled basically the secret history of how Labor Day came to celebrate. You know,
doing your very best to avoid labor.
Yeah.
Break any of these factoids out between drinks, whatever.
Yeah. So I thought it was pretty cool. So we will kind of read some of these and see if it's true or not. And by true, we don't care. So we just keep going with it. Yeah. So, here's the deal.
So apparently
Labor Day parade. Very first one was when
the Labor Day parade. I don't know.
1882, according to this article.
Yeah. Wait.
Yeah.
Oh.
Less than 20 years after the Civil War.
No. Okay. The first parade was held in Union Square in New York City and would be for decades to come.
Well, that was nice.
Yeah.
So 1882, right?
Yeah.
So, and despite its name, the Union Square has little to do with unions. It was originally named Union Place and blah, blah, blah. But anyway, Labor Dies. I cannot talk today. Labor Day was officially recognized to ease labor and unrest and prevent further violence. Okay? Mm-hmm. So in the years that bestowed or followed Labor Day Parade in 1882, Labor Day has been cropping up all around the country in tandem with general workers' movements, you know, because of the unions and things like that. In some states and municipalities regarded Labor Days as public holidays, right? And Oregon led the charge of this in 1887.
Yeah.
Yeah. But incidents like the Haymarket Affair and a decade later, the Pullman Strike of 1894, that pretty much galvanized politicians into action. So after President Grover Cleveland sent federal troops to Chicago to crush the strike that was occurring, right? This, I think, was the Pullman Strike. Dozens of people ultimately died. And then pretty much what it boiled down to is Labor Day became an official national holiday to sort of celebrate the laborers who were labored in the unions because of the strikes and everything else.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Did you know originally when it, like the very first one, it was still considered a work day?
Yeah.
So the workers involved in taking the day off purposely totaled in $75,000 in wages for that day. $75,000.
Well, that's a lot of money.
Back then, yeah.
That was like $2 billion.
It was. Yeah. It was $11 billion back then. Yes.
So pretty much it is. It has to do with unions and strikes and labor and all that stuff. And it's a day off to celebrate, supposedly celebrate,
yeah,
when I can see, you know, the strikes and all that sort of thing when it came to, you know, unions.
Hmm.
Yeah. So get the laborers in the unions, right?
Yeah.
So, in the early 20th century, as Labor Day came to signal the end of the, the unofficial end of summer,
yeah,
it made sense for individuals with means to wear breezy, comfortable white or light-colored cottons in the warmer months. And then once Labor Day rolled around and the conventional wisdom was to pack away your summer stuff, right,
yeah,
and to prepare for fall, and the winter pieces could not withstand rain and slush, so you put them away. So that's why you can't wear, or you're not supposed to wear white after Labor Day. See?
And supposedly, though, it was meant for, it was something that started with the upper crust or the rich people.
Well, yeah, it's still, yeah.
Since the rich people were the ones that could afford to wear those breezy, pretty, nice summer clothes.
Fine linens.
This was when you put them away so they wouldn't get destroyed.
Yeah, and it kind of makes sense that, yeah, you know, since Labor Day will occur, and I did this already, I've started packing away some of my short sleeves,
yeah,
and some summertime stuff because, number one, it's taking up room, and number two, it's going to be colder, I'm not going to wear them. Yeah. And I threw away a whole bunch of stuff that I didn't want to pack because I'm lazy, and what I've realized is that I didn't wear it, it doesn't fit, so why keep it?
Mm-hmm.
So, Labor Day, traditionally, when you put away your winter stuff, I'm sorry, your summer stuff, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, stuff that can't handle the rigors of wintertime, and you put that away, that's when you stop wearing it, and hence the you don't wear white after Labor Day.
Hmm. Yep. Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yes. What is it?
So, I thought that was kind of interesting, though. It's like, I mean, it kind of made sense, and I'd heard it a couple different ways.
Yeah.
The big thing I heard was the reason why you don't wear white after Labor Day is because you should be packing away all your spring and summertime stuff because you're getting ready for winter.
See, I was told it was bad luck, and I didn't even believe that. I was like, I don't get it.
That doesn't make any sense either.
Yeah, I know.
But, I mean, that's still something that's probably been heard as well because you're getting into the darker months. You know, I don't know. It should be, so, there you go. Take your pick.
Yeah.
You know, you were very rich, and you need to put away your fine linens because they can't handle the rigors of winter with slush and snow and all that stuff. Or you're just putting away to make room, or you need the good luck. I don't know. Just thought it was kind of weird.
Here's one that I found out because I was listening to the news, and it's in this article. Labor Day is still one of the most deadliest days of the entire year.
Yeah, fourth deadliest.
I'm like, what?
Enjoy Labor Day, the fourth deadliest holiday of the year.
For some reason, it is the second deadliest
in a world
behind Thanksgiving for total number of traffic fatalities in the United States. Yeah.
That's weird. I mean, I don't know. I can kind of see it with Thanksgiving because you do a lot of traveling, right? And you make a mistake and you wipe out an entire family of like five all in one shot. That's five deaths off one accident.
And plus Terrible. Since certain places are opening on Thanksgiving instead of waiting till Black Friday.
Walmart.
Yeah. There's been an increase.
Is the fourth deadliest shopping. What?
There's been an increase in traffic fatalities.
Yeah, because people are buttheads.
Yeah.
And if you can't wait, I mean, I'll tell you a little secret, everybody. Buy it online. It gets delivered to your house.
Yes. You don't have to fight
Cyber
crowds.
Monday. Yeah. You know what? Black Friday is for old people, like your parents. Better go stand in line. It's like, one of my ready, 3, 2, boom, pull the trigger, hit the enter button. Guess what's coming my way? Everything you're standing in line for.
Yeah.
Stupid. Because guess what? Better deals on Cyber Monday anyway.
That's true. But I think in the past 2 years, gotta get those
doorbusters.
In the past 2 years, certain companies have tried to like compete and offer just as good deals, but it's like limited. So if it's the first 100 people get something for free, that is it really worth?
To me, no, absolutely not.
So
I mean, you're talking to a guy. If I buy the wrong underwear, like wrong size or whatever, it's not going back. I should have known better. I should have thought more about it. I'm not standing in line to return it. I'm like, yep, I chose poorly, just like an Indiana Jones. Where the old, you know, the old Knight of the Templar was sitting there and said, like, "He chose poorly." When he turned to whatever that was,
yeah.
And he's like, "I can't make the sound effect because it's you know, I'm not Hollywood here, but you know what I'm talking about, right?"
Yeah, so you'd rather have your skin fall off and turn into a pile of dust because you bought the wrong underwear.
Yeah, man, that's what it is. If you choose poorly, I mean, that is what it is. That's it. Chose poorly. The only time I've ever returned anything, primarily, is because I've been meant or made to do it.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, yep, not doing it. Uh-huh. And I really like when people volunteer. You want me to return that? Heck yeah, because I don't want to. Especially if it's underwear.
Here's
the thing. I don't have any problem at all having somebody else return said underwear if I didn't buy it.
Yeah.
Like if you come home rocking like, hey, here you go. Here's your underwear. And it's like ladies medium, right? Because I'm a full-blown man, XXL. You know what I'm saying? Then I can't wear it.
Okay. You know,
if like one of my legs fills up the like, both leg holes, that's a problem. You know what I mean?
Okay.
Yeah. So anyway, there you go. That's some Labor Day statistics for you. It's a really deadly holiday. It was put together by unions to honorize, and not by unions, but just in general, the whole union movement, to sort of honorize laborers. And don't wear white after Labor Day. For whatever reason you pick, it's up to you. So pretty much the Labor Day holiday is really just as lame as we thought. In other words, it didn't really require this much effort into why we actually have a holiday. So just accept it and move on. You know what I mean? It's not like, let me research this and what's the real origins of the holiday. It's just a workers' holiday, man. It's all communist anyway. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah. See, the Father Labor Day. Anyway, we don't need to talk about it anymore. We're done. Hey, enjoy it.
Yeah.
Get some barbecue action. You know, go out there and do some shopping. Go get some, you know, something really cool, like some, you know, stuff like jewelry and all that stuff. Just go do what you got to do.
Jewelry?
Yeah. You know, kind of like what we did. We'll talk about that in a minute.
Okay.
So here is the deal. I seen this and I had to read this and I was like, wow. And okay, first off, IKEA.
Mm-hmm.
It's Swedish inspired, put together yourself DIY furniture. It's not really that good, right? Yeah. I mean, it can be, but for the most part, it's just kind of not my thing.
Yeah. I like it. I like a lot of it. So I think the price tag can be off-putting sometimes.
Off-putting.
Yeah.
Where's the closest IKEA? Isn't it like 120 miles away? No, it's more than that. It's like 275 miles away from here. We're in New Mexico, the land of no IKEA.
Let's see. If I type in.
We're going to go to IKEA.com and enter the zip code locator area there, enter our zip code and see what's closest to us.
Centennial, Colorado, 339 miles away.
Well, there you go. I was wrong. It is triple the distance I don't want to go anyway. So, okay. So, but every once in a while, I go to IKEA and I look around and stuff every once in a while. And every once in a while, something catches. There used to be a website called IKEA Hacks, which is pretty cool because people would buy IKEA stuff and sort of hack it to make some. So I always like that kind of ingenuity. But I ran across this article and I thought it was pretty funny. And it is funny because it says hilarious right in the title. So it must be good, right? Mm. It says man's hilarious complaint to IKEA after testicle gets trapped and shower stool is guaranteed to make you squirm.
Yuck.
Yeah.
I can't even. That's
me either. I was like, what? Anyway, and the guy is not that old. Okay. I mean, I can see if you're like 80 or something like that. I mean, things have a tendency to let gravity, you know, gravity has a stronger pull on you. But this guy's name is like Klaus Jorstad. So he's like Norwegian or something.
Uh-huh.
So he's already European. So that makes it kind of whatever, right?
Yeah.
And it says a man's Facebook post has gone viral after he got his genitals trapped in an IKEA stool while attempting to have a sit down in the shower. Okay.
Okay.
Politician and photographer. So he's a photographer/politician. Klaus, won't say his last name.
That's good.
45, struggles with bad knee and with a bad knee and needs to sit down in the shower. Right?
Yeah.
Very plausible. Makes sense. So he purchased a red stool, right? And the model is called Marius, at his local IKEA store to ensure that he would be comfy while having his daily wash.
Why would... Okay, that looks like a children's activity stool, if you look at it. I don't understand why you would use that model. They actually have shower
stools. It's a shower stool.
That
is a shower stool.
Okay, because to me it looks like a children's like playroom stool.
Well, to me it looks like a torture device after reading this article. So it's round and, you know, inset from the outside edge of the roundness is a set of circles that run all the way around it. And it looks almost like an old rotary telephone dial.
Yeah, I can see that.
So I guess dude's all perched down on his little stool there. And I don't know, Bob's your uncle. He's trapped, right? Something will plop and then you got to pop through the hole. I don't know. But basically he was stuck. he got one of his doodads stuck in the hole there. And there you go. And so basically what happened was after the painful incident, Klaus wrote on IKEA's Norwegian Facebook page. Okay, they're definitely Norwegian, right?
Yeah.
To complain about the stool, and his hilarious message has now been, his hilarious, I can't talk, message has been shared more than 13,000 times.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. I'm trying to use the translator on Facebook to read it, and it is beyond Swedish Chef. Yeah, but basically, his old lady left him home alone to take a shower. And he got his Dockers stuck in the store.
Yeah, see, this is what makes it good. Yes. The translation is awful.
And having the bunions worn out in the hole, so ending up making me to acquire the assistance.
So, I guess Facebook translates Norwegian testicles into onions.
Bunions.
Oh, bunions.
Yes.
Bunions. So pretty much what happened was is he got his bunions stuck, and I don't know how long it took him to get out, but he was pretty pretty vocal in his complaint. Mm.
Then again, if I see translation on IKEA's, it's actually not that great either. Like their reply, they're like, "Hi, Klaus." Derp a derp a do. And then, "It was sad to hear that your mainscoppin' been out in the Fuller Bell, and it almost got a job, the Bell, the Coast Guard."
Oh, I hate when that happens.
Yes. "We recommend that you tear the stool out of a plumber and put an ace flower on."
Hmm.
"You must be sure to be well-dressed for the next shower."
Nice.
Facebook, you are really winning at the translation here.
So basically what they're saying is, hey, dude, if you want to use that stool, you have a choice. You can get rid of it, or if you are going to use it, wear some clothes.
Yeah, and be sure to rip your flower out from it when it gets stuck.
Wow.
That's terrible.
So anyway, if you want to see this, there we go. And there's a little picture. It just shows that the solution would be...
to put a little towel over top of it.
But just put a little washcloth over it.
A little one. To protect your jewels. Yeah.
Yeah, your bunion.
Your bunion jewels.
There you go. And, you know, this person sends a little, he puts a picture of a cactus on top of said stool and says, "There you go. Now you won't be inclined to sit on it." Ugh. So there you go. If you want to see this stool in all of its glory, we have a link on our page. So when you follow the podcast, we actually put the show notes up there. And you can see a link of this testicle trapping stool from IKEA. And decide for yourself. It does come in multiple flavors, different colors, that is. Yeah. So if you want to be able to maybe pick something that's more complimentary, you certainly can. But links are there, so you can peruse at your leisure.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Isn't that horrible?
It is. I can't imagine because...
So, I mean, you're stuck, right? I mean, you can't... You're stuck. Your old lady's gone because she went to the docking store. And you're stuck. You got your bunions stuck on the flower or stool, whatever. What do? You're just like, man, I hope the water does. I mean, you're eventually going to, the water's going to get cold.
Yeah.
So then you have to turn it off and you just have to sit there and think about what you've done. You're like, man, this is awful. So, and it's terrible, right? And it's a terrible way to be. Same thing that happened to us, sort of. We had a terrible thing, but it's been fixed. It's done. It's over.
Yeah.
And hey, it could have been much worse. Could have been like this, dude. See, because here's the thing. Having your bunion, or whatever they're calling it, stuck in a stool, is a huge inconvenience.
Yes.
You know what I mean? What happened to us is a huge inconvenience. In the grand scheme of things, you know, I mean, yeah, whatever, it happened. But it's an inconvenience. That's why I just don't want to be inconvenienced, you know? It's not so much the situation, it's the inconvenience behind the whole thing. And we'll tell you about what happened to us in just a second. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a commercial. And by take a commercial, we're just not going to talk for a minute. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because we don't really have any commercial stuff. Okay, so basically what that boiled down to is that we had to take a little break, get a little bit of water so we can get back to going what we're doing. So anyway, after I read that, I was thinking, man, this is pretty awful, right? Because that's a pretty terrible thing. And then I started to look at some like cringeworthy workplace stories, and I'm like, well, that's pretty cool. And you can read those for yourself. We put them there as, you know, I'll tell you about one of them, okay? Yep, there's a bunch of cringeworthy stories, but this is the one I like, okay?
Yeah.
Okay, and it goes like this. Bemused workman returns to a pile of rubble to find a pig taking a nap on it.
I don't see how that's cringeworthy. I think it's kind of cute.
It's not really cringeworthy. But see, the guy's a laborer, right? He's going back to work, and there's this big pig laying in all of his stuff.
Now, it is a huge pig.
Yeah, it's
a
hog,
that thing looks like...
Yeah. So he's kind of stuck, right? Yeah. And the police had to call in to deal with this rogue swine.
Oh, it's a Shetland swine.
Yeah.
That's what it's called. Named Mocha.
So this guy's job is to dig this hole, and he finds this big pig just chilling and sleeping on top of his rubble.
Yeah.
So now, I mean, you know, can't get his job done. Probably got fired.
Don't say that.
So, you know, he got fired.
Yeah.
So it's pretty bad.
I think it's cute, though.
So I seen the pig, and it is a pretty cool looking pig. And the pig, he's just laying there. He's like, you know what? I'm a pig, man. That's what I do.
Apparently they lured him away with the help of leftover tipples.
What's that?
I don't know. And then lured him back around, I guess, because they had to get him out of the pile. So whatever tipples are, they lured him with those. Then they used crisps. And here's
which
the
are
gross,
like British potato peas.
Yeah, chips. Gross part. Pork scratchings and carrots.
So they basically fed him the food of his own people.
I'm wondering if pork scratchings are like pork rind.
Maybe.
That's kind of messed up.
Yeah. Ugh. Yeah. So he was just chilling, just laying there, and this guy couldn't do it. So I thought that was all right. But, you know, the cringeworthy stuff, you can read yourself. We have a link to it.
Mm-hmm.
So you can click on the link. It's called Cringeworthy Workplace Stories. But this is the one I thought was actually pretty cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. Ready?
What?
Terrified woman claims she saw an 8-foot-tall fanged werewolf walking on two legs.
Whatever. don't believe that.
It's true.
Okay.
Click it.
I am.
Okay, there's the obligatory selfie.
Yeah.
Right? Of her name and her face. They're a little making...
Gemma Waller. That's
Gemma Waller, right?
Familiar.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She was terrified when she saw the 8-foot beast, right?
Uh-huh.
And it says, a terrified woman says she saw an 8-foot fanged werewolf walking on two legs down a country lane. Right?
Mm-hmm.
She said it was like a big dog, probably bigger than my car, but it had a human face.
Her car looks like it's a Ford Escape. Or not
I mean, you know.
Yeah.
It's England, right?
Yeah.
Or it's Europe. It's probably UK. Thanks for saying it. Yeah. And it says, over the years, others have claimed to also seen the creature known as Old Stinker.
Old Stinker?
Yeah.
In the Yorkshire Woods? They spelled woods. It's supposed to be woods, right?
Yeah.
And they spelled it a couple times in here, W-O-L-D-S.
I think wood, well, anyway, we'll just call it the woods.
Yeah.
Right. So Jim is an animal rescue worker. She was driving with two friends to go to Howsham East Yorks when she spotted it. The beast on all fours started to walk to my car on two legs. It was like a horror movie.
Oh.
And then staff at a fuel station, which is a gas station, basically told them the story of the gray and cream stalker that dates back to the 18th century.
Yeah.
Yeah. So here's what makes it kind of weird, all right? So she says she sees this thing.
Yeah.
You know? And it's been reported to have been seen in that area for a long time. So, I mean, back from, what, 1800s?
Yeah.
So that's what gives us a little bit of credence there, is that, hey, there's something going on, you know?
And there was a rumor that the city council had a policy for dealing with werewolves, but apparently a Freedom of Information request proved that to be wrong.
Yeah.
Yeah. But, I mean, that's how common the complaints or the reports are of this little werewolf thing.
Hmm.
And it seems to have really started, like picked up big time in the 1960s. A lorry driver said a creature had tried to smash its way through his windscreen as he drove along the remote woods road.
Yeah.
So, I mean,
it's the beast of the Barnstorm drain.
Now, this is in England or Europe, right?
Yeah, it's in England.
We should eventually do a podcast on, like, skinwalkers out here.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Skinwalkers.
Or chupacabra.
Yeah.
So, yeah. But I don't know. The article starts off with a selfie. The girl's name sounds familiar, like she's on Instagram or something. So I kind of call BS on this.
I don't know.
Yeah.
It's right there. Sighting is of old stinker. Are believed to date back to the 18th century when wolves still stalked the countryside.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
So who knows? But I thought, like, whoa, that's pretty neat. So anyway, and plus, you know, you name your werewolf Old Stinker.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's just Old Stinker. Like, what? So, yeah, 8 foot tall, half dog man, face. So, yeah, I thought that was kind of cool. And then pretty much as I was kind of going my research, because that's what I call this when I find fun stuff on the internet is research. This is what I thought was actually pretty funny. Mm-hmm. And it kind of goes like this. Shameful SpongeBob SquarePants brawls in park with giant hedgehog and bizarre fight caught on camera. And this is in England as well. I'm like, what?
Yeah.
How dare you, right? So here's pretty much what the deal is. You got these two guys, and they play characters, right? And they're out there in the park, and they're wearing their little costumes. And
is it like
there's actual
what kind of hedgehog? I was thinking it would be like Sonic the Hedgehog.
No,
or
it's
something.
Like part of a Russian show. But here's the
thing. Oh, okay.
It's like a Russian kid show from an anime children's series.
Oh, okay.
It's like Kikariki or whatever you say.
Yeah, but this is described as the Mortal Kombat of children's animations.
Yeah, and you know they're at the park, right? You got the little kids out there; they're celebrating and stuff like that. This is the odd moment. Two men dressed as children's cartoon characters started fighting in a city park. The pair, one of them dressed as SpongeBob SquarePants, exchanged punches and kicks before they were dragged apart by security guards. And a bizarre brawl took out during the International Children's Day celebrations. This is in Russia.
Yeah.
So, and there's like, there's pictures.
Okay, so apparently they could not agree on the controlled territory during the children's event.
Yeah, so it turned into a kung fu fight.
So don't step in my territory, SpongeBob. This is my turf. Right?
In International Children's Day, they are beating the crap out of each other.
In front of children.
Yeah, and the funny thing is that the duo exchanged martial arts style kicks and blows before SpongeBob eventually fell his opponent with a spinning back kick. So SpongeBob SquarePants knocked out to do with a spinning back kick.
He immediately jumps on top of the downed hedgehog to finish him off, but security guards leap in and drag the pair apart.
So not only are they just scuffling, they are kung fu fighting. That would be the best International Children's Day I've seen. It's like, whoa. Because it's like, yes. He drops the dude with a spinning back kit.
You know what's messed up? They have the pictures in here. There's not a single link to the video.
No.
I can't find. I would watch that video. So,
yeah, it looks great. And so there's some pictures and there's a link.
Yeah.
You know, and it may not be real. It may be staged. I don't know. But any time you can see SpongeBob SquarePants do a spinning back kick and lay out some Russian kiki, whatever that thing is. I mean, hey, it'd been better if it was like Patrick and SpongeBob fighting each other.
Oh, there it is.
Starfish. So, yeah, we have links so you can kind of check that out. You have the video?
Yeah, I just found it.
Ooh, yep. Very nice. You should put a link. You jumping front kick. Oh, wait, I got to see it. Hopefully, I was like, finish him. Look, there he goes. SpongeBob squaring off, man. Full screen. Oh. And here we go. There's a left and a right from the thing. Spinning back kick. Boom. Laid him out. Bam.
Oh, a replay.
And boom. Hits him. Little Muay Thai. Little Muay Thai right there. And wait. He's going right for his shins. He's like, oh, ooh.
Oh.
Man. And there it is, spinning back kick. Wow. We'll put a link to that so you can watch it at your leisure. I think it keeps going on. Anyway, who knew SpongeBob was such a badass?
I know, right?
I mean, you know he's an excellent fry cook, but no idea. We had some Krabby Patties today. So I thought, you know, it's funny because they put shameful. Shameful. Yeah. That was a shameful. But I thought it was amazing. Of course, if I had, you know.
It has to be a prank.
Yeah.
It has to be. But
I don't know. I thought this was a prank.
Yeah.
Paranormal investigators chase blue humanoid creature with a glowing skull before it disappears into thin air.
Oh, I was trying to watch this, and
I think it's crap.
I think it's totally fake.
It looks like a drone to me, and then it turned off, and it's like a balloon drone. And
like a low-flying drone?
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
They kind of show it floating around. It's like, what could this bizarre blue glowing creature be? It could be a hoax.
It could be a drone.
It could be. I mean, who knows what it is.
And then it could just be they tracked the drone and used it as something, you know, a point in Photoshop or whatever they do, some image editing program. Because it fades in and out a couple of times and not in a natural way at all.
Yeah.
And, oh, wait, no. So when one of the trucks, for some reason, it's running away from the camera person and it's in the highway and... Okay, it tries to cross a busy highway, and it looks like, kind of like a jellyfish, like a mechanical metal jellyfish, but the light reflects off of it on one truck when a big giant truck passes by it, but it doesn't look real at all. That's the weird thing.
I think this is a balloon drone or something like that. I don't think it was really either, but I figured I'd put it in there because why not?
Yeah.
I was looking at dumb stuff, so I'm like, Yeah.
So, and this happened in Peru. Where all the hoaxes come from.
Yeah, Peru and Mexico have lots of hoaxes, by the way.
Whatever. It makes me mad because I'd like for us to start finding like some real stuff, but it's just a bunch of hoaxes.
Bunch of hoax.
Yep.
Hoaxers. Yeah. So anyway, I thought I'd put that in there so you can watch that video. There's a link to it as well. And, you know, because what we're doing is we're working down to a thing. So this is the section of the show where we talk about binge-worthy BS. These are shows that you can watch on the television, whether it be Netflix or Amazon Prime, whatever it is. We have lots of episodes where you can watch them back to back to back and just binge, man, a little binge-worthy. And what do you think it is? I'll tell you.
Okay.
Narcos. Narcos on Netflix. It's the story of Pablo Escobar.
Yeah.
He was a huge drug dude. Back in the day, back when cocaine got cool and became real popular back in the old my. So anyway, it's the story of Pablo Escobar, and it's kind of an ongoing sort of show. It has a little bit of narration going on there, and it so far has been really good.
I'm torn. It can be very good. Sometimes it's just a little too gruff for me.
Well, yeah, but, I mean, it's a drug lord. So
it is at least a rated R show. Well,
yeah.
So
yeah, I was getting that.
Yeah.
There's lots of gratuitous nudity. Not lots of it. I mean, it's there.
And some point-blank violence.
Well, yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
So.
Yeah. I mean, Escobar killed like thousands of people.
Yeah.
Or had thousands of people killed. But it's not bad. So if you're looking for an adult show to sort of talk about this sort of thing, I'm trying to think of what show it reminds me of. It's narrated a little bit, you know. But, I mean, it's a good show. Second season's coming. You can watch, I believe there's 10 or 15 episodes so far are coming to get ready to be. And I think they're going to do a season 3, and it won some awards. So it's a pretty good show. It's called Narcos, and it's on Netflix.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. So over on our YouTube channels, I pretty much don't really have anything to put down there except that I did a video review on a USB safety charger.
Yeah.
It's all made out of metal. It's super heavy duty. It has a cutter built into it. It charges your USB device. It has two USB charging ports on there. And it has this nice little crazy pointy tip at the very end of it so you can crack out a window or something like that if you need to.
Yeah.
And I thought it was pretty cool. It's really heavy. It feels heavy duty. And I'm like, you know what? You never know. You might need it. And plus, it's a charger. Yes. And I've got some comments like...
It's not... This is a car charger, not a piece of candy.
Yeah, people are like, you know, hey, you can choke on that.
Yes.
Basically. And that's why it's not safe, is what they're saying. It's my phone, baby.
Yes.
It's like, hey.
During a podcast.
Oh, like yours was doing.
Nope.
So, oh, the one time you remember to silence your phone, you're like, oh, how dare ye. But anyway, and that's kind of what struck me. It's like, okay, if you watch the video, I talk about it. It's USB. And, you know, one of the comments was, is that, you know, oh, that might present a choking hazard, effectively, is what they're saying.
Yeah.
And my thought, and the next comment underneath it was like, and that's why it's not safe. It's like, well, hold on a second, man. Okay, first off, USB car chargers are not meant for your mouth.
Who puts car chargers in their mouth?
I don't know. But, I mean, yeah, you can choke on it. You can choke on a gumball. You know, you can choke on a jawbreaker. You can choke on a rock. Mm-hmm. You can choke on a bottle cap. You can choke on a screwdriver. You can choke on anything that you put in your mouth that's not designed to go in your mouth. And you can also choke on things that are designed to go in your mouth, like food.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I don't understand exactly what the reasoning was behind putting a comment that said that basically you can choke on that and that's why it's not safe. I'm hoping it's a joke because otherwise people need to pay attention to their children's. It's like, I wouldn't put it in my mouth. It's a charger. I would plug in my phone cable after I plug it into my car.
It doesn't even look like candy.
No, it's like it doesn't look tasty at all. It's all metal.
I mean,
anodized body.
I mean, it is the ugliest ring pop I have ever seen. Okay.
Yeah.
And I used to choke on those as a little kid because I ate them wrong.
Yeah.
So
I was like, what? Okay. So there'll be a link to that. So you can, if you want to watch that, you certainly can.
Yeah.
But if you do buy one of those, and I think about $13 off of Amazon, just remember, it's not for your mouth.
It's not a piece of candy.
And then, and another comment I got was like, when's the last time you had to cut yourself out of your seatbelt or break out your window? Never, but if I have to, I would like to be able to.
Yeah.
I mean, you know.
Oh, I didn't see the window one that you said.
Well, it's kind of like, what? Okay.
Yeah.
So, I mean, you know, that's what it is. And that's sort of the thing on there. And we have a couple of videos off leftovers for dinner. It'll be going up pretty soon. We have one that's basically the action camera storage case, which is pretty cool. And I know it's got you all choked up.
He's so emotional.
So emotional. Mm-hmm. And pretty much here's what happened to us. We got robbed.
Really?
Yeah. I've been waiting to say it the whole time. It's kind of why we're doing a podcast, because that's part of the title. See, Labor Day, IKEA testicle, stool, and we got robbed.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So basically what it boils down to is we got robbed. We went to this place to look at some jewelry.
Actually.
Making supply stuff.
We went to...
What's it called?
A bead and leather supply store.
A bead and leather
supply store. It's actually a very popular one. People come from other states to go to it.
And they come there and they were just, you know, taking... Yes. And Robin.
So we went to one of the very well-known leatherworking and bead supply shops in Albuquerque.
Yes.
Parked on the side of the building.
Yes.
We were only in the building for maybe about 20 minutes. Maybe?
Yeah.
Barely 20 minutes.
Yeah, because I wasn't sick of the place.
Yeah.
You know, it usually takes me about 45 minutes. I'm like, I'm done.
Mm-hmm.
So I was just wandering around, occupying myself.
But there was some cool stuff. And all of a sudden, somebody... says over the overhead, would the owners of a big white van please come to the front desk?
Now, first, I'm not so self-centered or absorbed that I would think that anybody that has a big white van, right,
mm-hmm.
that mine is like more important or whatever. It's like, I wouldn't, you know, it's like, oh, that must be me. It's all about me. But no, everywhere we've gone, we have a big white van. It's big. I mean, it really is. There's no missing it. It is a big white van. So when we pulled in and parked, I see no other vehicle that was anywhere close to being the same descriptive terms used to describe itself as our Great White Buffalo, our DIY camper van, our big giant white van, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So we go outside and somebody had decided to bust out our passenger window and steal. Theft. They took something that belonged to me.
Actually, they didn't just do that. They also...
I'm not done yet.
Yeah.
I'm being dramatic and you just like wrecked it.
Yes.
They took my freaking GPS.
Uh-huh.
That's it. That's all I got.
They also pried open one of the doors.
Well, they didn't. They pried open the window to unlock the window, to reach around and unlock the door.
Which is stupid.
No, that's great. Yeah. I'd been super cool if they had just did that. But no. What did they do? They had to slam the door on the way by or do whatever, and it broke out the door. Broke out the glass. The passenger side door glass was busted everywhere, all over the place.
Yeah.
Yeah. for a stupid GPS. And the thing is, we hadn't been in the store that long. People were like, you know, you should. And the people, the three people who were listening, be like, well, you probably should have had that stuff out in view. It's like, yeah, because that's just asking for it, right?
Mm-hmm.
I like when people say that. Well, you know, you're just asking for it. It's yeah. like, okay, it's just like, when do women like, do they get asked to be raped when they wear like a nice shirt?
No.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
So, no, it's fully their fault. So here's the deal.
Yeah.
They broke out the window. It's a huge inconvenience.
It is.
It's not nearly as inconvenient as getting your testicles stuck in a stool. Which would hurt.
Well, here was the.
It's an inconvenience. It's like, why would you break out my freaking window for a $20 GPS?
Especially when you were able to get in through the other door.
Yeah.
I mean,
unlocked it, you know, it's like, what?
And then, further inconvenience, we had a witness, and he was very cool. Him and his lady and their kid, they saw basically the whole thing. And, you know, they were willing to wait around for the cops.
Yeah.
Cops never showed up.
Yeah, we called the cops, and they're like, hey, we're really busy. Can you call this other number? We called 911, right, because that's what you're supposed to do. They're like, hey, we're really busy. Can you call this other number? Like, mm-hmm. Okay.
And then
they're like, hey, we're really busy.
The other number.
It's like, okay.
We'll send somebody out since you have a witness, but we can't tell you because it's so busy today.
Yeah, we can't tell you when.
Yeah.
So I was like, okay.
So
I understand being busy.
Yeah.
And so we waited around like an hour, and I'm like, okay, you know what? We're done.
Over an hour.
Yeah. So we called the insurance company. Insurance company really wasn't very useful to us at all. And then we actually called. They transferred us to Safe Light Auto Glass, a place that's supposed to come and repair your auto glass for all your auto glass repair needs, right?
Mm-hmm.
And they're like, yeah, it's going to cost $500. I'm like, okay, what? No, that's not right. You need to look this up. And the lady who we talked to at Safe Light Auto Glass sounded like she's about 12 and had no idea. First off, she couldn't pronounce my last name. She spelled it to me, still couldn't pronounce it, and that's okay. You don't need to say what it is. I know you're trying to say what it is on the phone. Or on the, no. And then tried to tell me that I didn't have the deductibles for it. And I'm like, well, how do you know? And so she's like, well, you know, let me see if we can do something better on the price. The price was $504.50 for a passenger side window, not a windshield, a window. I'm like, okay. So she comes back and says, well, I talked to Hector, and Hector said they could do it for $246.75. Is that more to your liking? I'm like, no.
She had already said that line to me.
I know. And I'm like, I said, first off, that's too much.
Yeah.
I said, you know, I can do it myself. I said, so, and she's like, well, I'm like, here's the deal. You've been really unhelpful. I got to go. She couldn't get my name right, couldn't get the policy right, couldn't get the vehicle right, couldn't get the price right. It just became, I'm like, I don't have time for this.
Yeah.
And I checked, right?
Yeah.
Because supposedly they filed a claim for us. We have three outstanding claims on our insurance policy because of the person that they transferred us to.
Yeah. And I told you part of that was because she tried to pull you up through the wrong way.
So I'm like, hold on a second. And so I'm looking at my insurance policy. We have a glass policy deductible there. And it's like, okay. So now I have to call my insurance, which is USAA, on Tuesday when Labor Day is over.
Yeah.
And say, no, I'm not trying to claim four different things on the same window.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, I want to cancel them all. Because here's the deal. Did a little research and found out a couple different things. The glass, okay, the door glass, was not going to be $500. I mean, that's $500 including installation, so that would make the price of the glass for about a 45-minute job if you don't know what you're doing.
Yeah.
You know, like $300-$400. No. The price of the glass on Rock Auto, and if you get auto parts, if you're going to buy them online, it's a couple different places you should do. One of them is Rock Auto Parts, right?
Yep.
Guess how much? $78.
Yeah. I was going to say about $80.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I get home and check on Amazon.com. See, because you go to RockAuto.com and you get the part number. Then you go to Amazon and throw the part number and you search and you do a search, and guess what I found?
What?
Same glass, $63. Okay, $63 plus $12.75 shipping. It'll be there in like 5 days. So almost the same cost, but with shipping included as Rock Auto would be. So Rock Auto with the shipping cost would have brought it to about $90.
Yeah.
Okay. So now we're down to like $78 roughly all together. If I get it from Amazon, it'll be here like Friday, like 4 days later.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, okay, well, that's a little much. So what I would have done in the past was immediately go to a junkyard and get a piece of glass.
Yeah.
And I'm like, you know, let me look at it and see. And see, I really like the van that we have. I do. I like it. We've been taking care of it. It looks nice. It's not too bad. You know, it's not all. And the last thing I wanted to do is put some scratched up piece of junkyard window glass in the car or in the van. But when I found it for $25.99, I'm like, guess what? We're going to go get a piece of scratched up glass and stick it in the van. Because $25, I mean, so, okay, so if you look at the price of the car, right? I mean, if you look at the price, the original quote was $500. And then, right?
Yeah, immediately.
$250. Okay, so the median price for the installation was $250. Mm-hmm. We got the, effectively, we got the window glass for $25. A tenth of the cost.
Yeah.
A tenth. Of the cost. And, okay, my labor in this case is not necessarily free because it costs you some hamburgers.
Yeah, that's right? true.
And a soda. But even so, even if I charged myself $100 an hour, it was $125. It would be 50% cheaper than them coming out and doing the installation.
Yeah.
Them coming out and doing it. Yep. So, that's what happened. We got robbed. They stole a GPS. You want to hear the funny thing?
Yeah.
If these stupid criminal, and you know, it's got to be a smash and grab. These guys are hard up, right? Because it was a ball headed dude. Anyway, they didn't get the like 22 mile range walkie talkies we have that are in there.
No.
They didn't get my camera, which I carry everywhere, which is in there. They didn't get the super cool USB chargers that we have in there for camera gear and everything else. They didn't get the USB cable I just paid $20 for because it's super awesome. They didn't get my tablet.
Nope.
They didn't get my other monitor. You know, they didn't get anything good. They grabbed a crappy GPS out of the cradle with no power cord.
They didn't get the Einstein Bagels gift card.
Ah, they didn't get this $7 Einstein Bagels gift card.
They didn't get, I had stuffed some of my stuff under the front seat. They didn't get any of that either.
They didn't get any girl stuff.
Yeah. Oh. Like
perfume and I don't know.
He whatever. Did grab something. I just realized it.
What?
I think he grabbed my $2 that was in a pink makeup bag that was in the cup holder.
Do you still have the pink makeup bag?
No.
I think it's underneath the seat.
Okay. I hope so. Yeah.
Anyway, this dumbass only got like a GPS that if you unplug it from the cradle lasts for like 5 minutes before it says, please charge me. It's an old crap. We had just talked about getting rid of that stupid GPS and buying a different one.
Funny thing, yeah. I had threatened to throw it out the window earlier in the day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, joke's on you, sucker. If I wasn't a fully equipped man, which I am, with all my skills and stuff, I might be a little mad about it. But I'm not now.
Yeah.
I got to go to the junkyard with my woman. We explored and looked at some different things. Built some stuff. Even bought a seat base pedestal swivel feature.
Yeah.
In other words, I'm going to take the seat that's in the passenger seat. I'm going to put a swivel on it, and you'll be able to swivel around. It's really cool. Normally $89. Paid $9 for it. So, joke's on you, butthead. And I hope your GPS sucks.
I know, right?
I hope you get explosive diarrhea. Uncontrollable explosive diarrhea is my wish for you, my friend. And then get some help.
Yeah.
Because with explosive diarrhea, you need it. So you know what makes the explosive diarrhea good, right?
What?
It adds an element of danger to it. Explosive. You call into work with that, hey, man, I can't come in today. I have explosive diarrhea. They're like, dude, stay home. Stay away, man. Please, stay home. Because you're in there, you might get, you know, it's explosive. It might get on you. Awful.
It makes me mad because
they can't hear you because you're not speaking into
the microphone. I am speaking into it. It makes me mad. We've been in New Mexico for just barely over a year. Yeah. So we've been here
a year and 5 months.
No. June, July, August.
What is that? 15 months.
Yeah, 15 months.
Okay, well, that's so we've a been month here and a third.
1 year and 3 months, and in that time, my car has been backed into.
Yeah.
I've been attacked by a pit bull.
Yeah.
Let's see. I've almost been hit once.
Yeah.
And now we have our car broken into.
Yeah.
Yeah, getting kind of tired of it. Hmm. It's very depressing. Granted, you look at the news here, and there's so many more terrible things happening to other people.
Yeah. I mean, for example, you could be sitting in the shower because you have a bum knee and get your testicle completely stuck in a stool.
I'm talking about here in New Mexico.
That can happen anywhere.
Okay.
Well, no, actually can't here. Not necessarily. The likelihood of that actually happening here, if you are listening and you're from New Mexico, pretty slim because there's IKEA is like 300 plus feet away, 300 plus
miles,
326, yeah.
339 miles.
That's a long way to go for a testicle eating stool, I'll tell you that.
But it's just, there's all this bad stuff out here and it's really starting to get me down.
Yeah.
So.
It is what it is. But anyway, guess what? We got it fixed.
Yes.
Because we're capable. Capable people. So you. Oh, and by the way, we did buy some stuff that we needed for the van anyway, like a little knob, some knick-knack stuff, right, that I had broken a long time ago. So we got that. We actually got a swivel seat base, which is normally $89. It's not a big deal unless you're doing a camper van. And the glass, and the entire thing was how much?
$53.
$53. And if you add the $13 that we went to McDonald's, because it was close, how much is that?
$6.
Just say $70. So we got a whole bunch of additional stuff. Got some quality bonding time. Got a little lunch, and we got it all done and fixed and repaired for under the original cost, or actually for under the less cost off Amazon, which is like $78. So anyway, it wasn't that bad.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, just an inconvenience, and it did rain a little bit. But you know, I do appreciate you taking the time to do the trash bag window thing.
It just,
it's very nice.
And you know, we decided to stay local for Labor Day because we didn't want to go travel and, you know, spend a lot of money.
Kind of wishing maybe we went and went somewhere.
Yeah, because at least if we had gone someplace, you know, who knows, would somebody have smashed a window just for a dinky GPS?
Yeah, or would they have taken the van completely? We could have been walking out in the woods somewhere and come back and it's just gone completely. That's my fear.
That's my fear here in New Mexico.
Well, that's what I'm saying. I'm going to fix that. I'm going to make it hard to steal the van.
Okay.
So that's what I'm working on. And I'm not going to tell you how I'm going to do it. It's a secret, but I will make a video.
Yes.
Yeah, and put it on YouTube because, I mean, I'm going to do it for pretty inexpensive. I mean, there's a couple of different ways you could do it, but I'm going to do it the easiest way that's convenient.
Are you going
to? Because I'm tired of being inconvenienced.
You're going to put the other video about the van up too?
What video about the van?
Like.
Which one?
Like when we discovered it had been broken into.
Well, yeah, I'm going to do that, but don't give it away because that's going to come later. I have scheduled videos in advance, and you are giving away a glimpse of the future that no one should be ready to see yet.
All right.
So anyway, if you are listening to the Cheap Geek podcast, very much appreciated. And if you're listening to the Labor Day podcast for the very first time, it's only going to happen once a year, so next time should be better.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, anyway, so that's about all I got. So if you have the day off, good for you.
Yeah.
If you're listening tomorrow and you're on your way to work, I do apologize in advance. Just so you know, I'll be right there with you, but I'm going to sleep in late because I can't. So anyway, that's all I got. You got anything?
No.
All right.
I like peanut butter.
See you later.
I like peanut butter.
Take it easy. Bye-bye.
Peanut butter. I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter. I like peanut butter.